And let's start the session. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the first speaker, Toastmaster Essensor, is going to deliver his first speech. Competent communication panel, project number one, the icebreaker. The objective of the speech is to begin speaking before the audience, to discover speaking skills you already have and skills that need some attention. Time given is 4 to 6 minutes. Can our timekeeper demonstrate the time for us? At 4 minutes, green light turn on. 5 minutes, amber light turn on. 6 minutes, green light turn on. And six, of course, icebreaker, there is no bell ring. Right. All right. Essensor is an independent financial advisor from Whitman Independent Advisor to provide holistic wealth and management service and family office advisory service. Today, Essensor is going to deliver his icebreaker speech with either ADZ value with PE concept. ADC ADZ value with PE concept, Essensor.
Thank you, Toastmaster, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
Okay, so who is Essensor? Okay, Essensor is a person who holds a value, so called X value, with PE concept. Okay, X value for the first point include for the user, mean the quality of unselfish concern for the welfare of others. Second, for D, deliberate, carefully thought out in advance. Third is zest, strong passion on some method. Okay, so today I discover another A's, which is a prod. Okay, so this could be applied to my value as well. Throughout the journey of this speech on how I become an independent financial advisor, you will able to see how this ADZ value with PE's concept being applied and get to know me better. Okay, so let's get started and welcome to Essensor World. I'm actually graduate from Park College with general degree in financial accounting. Okay, so I start my first job in a small audit firm as an auditor. Okay, after 2 weeks later, I have been assigned to handle the case independently. Okay, so I can say that I might be the fast learner here. Okay. Throughout my service in this line, I get to develop accounting, auditing, and taxation skills, which is very useful for my current position. Okay. So after that, I got the opportunity. I get to know another offer from a multinational company. Work as a finance executive. As you know, as a finance personnel, okay, always facing the figure and then doing the paperwork, data entry, and prepare for some reporting. This job is really boring. But I'm glad that I got the chance to work with a good leader who create a good learning working culture in the company, so that I have got the chance to prepare some proposal on how to improve the process effectiveness and with cost efficiency. So from there, I developed some analytical skill from there. And then after 1 year later, I get promoted to be a team leader for a team. At that point, I was thinking that I might be just climb for the corporate ladder. Okay, but the good time did not last for long. After the good leader retired, then replaced with another managing director with his team, then the corporate culture start changing, and then the politics start to begin. After that, at that time, I met a friend. He was an insurance agent who shared with me about the medical plan. After I listened to him, that I found that hey, this medical plan is good. Maybe I can get one for my mom. After that, I do more research about insurance, and I get to know insurance is one of the effective risk management tool for a family financial planning. Okay. Over the period of disappointment about the organization politics, as a young man at the time, I think, why not I give a try to another industry, which is insurance. So why I certainly think so? Because I think that some of many people from different background can be an insurance agent, and some of them doing quite well. Okay, so I'm in my view that maybe I can, with my strength, I apply in this industry. With my analytical skill strength, I can provide some professional service to the society, and I think should be not bad as well. After that, I joined my friends for his agency. After that, I have start to learn about marketing skill and some hot selling insurance product. And they also trained me on how to present it to enhance the closing rate. After I do a further research about the plan, I was shocked. The plan is not that the effective return is not that attractive as we presented. So from day onwards, I did not vote for the that particular income plan. Okay, so after that, but one senior asked me, "Hey, Azansa, why you so stupid? What easy money don't want to earn?" So at that time, I was thinking, maybe I'm really stupid, but I get it to me. After that, I asked the senior also the question about how about the claim procedure. Then the senior told me, "Now you no need to know about it lah. When you focus to get more client first, until got claim issue, then you will get to know it." But I totally disagree about this. So I spend my own more time to get the information and study it. Okay. After that, I also study other products, not just the hot selling products, for my analytical. So after that, I apply my strategy to provide the analytical approach to the society. I meet the person. What I do is that I not only share with the client about the benefit of the plans. Moreover, I highlight about the con side so that the client aware about the side effect and make the final decision. After a year later, I discover something not right because my effort and the time that I spent not match with my income. Okay, so I discover there is some limitation in my analytical approach. So what I found out is that first, this thing is on Because I'm tied as a tied agent in one insurance company, what I have done is that I do the end comparison analysis with my client, not only for the plan in my company, over from other insurance company. Sometimes I have found that some other company's plan is better than mine. So I don't know how to convince the client, say this, my plan is most suitable for you. So I don't know how to do that. So I asked the client, hey, take that one. By doing so, with all the time for me to do the research, comparison, and the discussion, and my effort bring me zero. Okay, but after that, I also discovered another limitation of this analytical approach is that, because for me, insurance is just for the protection purpose. I did not promote for the insurance for investment purpose. So for an insurance agent who just take propose for the reasonable premium for the protection plan only, got a lot of responsibility, but the time for the service is very heavy. Okay, so after I discovered this limitation, I was thinking that should I change myself to fit this industry? At that time, I registered and attend for a financial planning workshop. From there, I discovered two important information that have affect my career future. First thing I discovered is that there is a professional, so-called independent financial advisor available in Malaysia. Second is that I was impressed by the trainer who conducted the workshop. And after that, I tried to chat with him. Then he shared with me about Toastmaster Club. But that was a few years ago. But at that point, I did not explore about Toastmaster yet. I take the decision to explore about the independent financial advisor first. After that, I do more research about the IFA, and then try to understand how could this impact about my existing client. And then I go and visit my client, explain the situation to them. Then I'm glad that most of my client is very supportive and encourage me to become a professional IFA. And then I think for the exam and pass all the professional paper for the first attempt. This is the beginning of the journey as an IFA. So actually I got most interesting story to share in this case, but due to the time constraint, I might cut it short. Okay, so with the so now I would like to share about my ambition. Okay, my ambition is to provide a financial shield to every family household that eventually they can have a balanced and healthy quality life without the stress from the unorganized finance management. Finally, I would like to urge everyone here that when you see Azenza is on the low power condition, please do not hesitate to share your smile with positive energy to Azenza so that Azenza can continue to stand strong and move forward to share more adds value to the society. Thank you.